Hello and welcome to the Sites and Equipment tutorial. In this tutorial we're going to go through an overview of how you can create sites and how you can create pieces of equipment for that site and the things that surround the sites and equipment as well, so you can get an idea of seeing equipment history and also site history as well. So the first thing we'll do is we'll go to a customer. We're going to just use Aldi supermarkets here at the top, and we're going to go to the tab sites. So you'll see that you've got all your sites here, so you've got head office and all the supermarkets. And then you've also got the equipments for the site that you selected at the top here. So for example, if I go to supermarket 1, you can see we've got a compressor here, supermarket 3 and 4, and then 4 we've got all these, and then in the head office we've got some of these pieces of equipment as well at the bottom here. So to create a site, you can simply just create on new, just on here, so on sites new, and then click on new site, and then you can start typing in the details of that site. So once you've filled in the details of that site, you can just click on save on there and that'll be saved. Now whilst you're in the site, you might see there's a few things here that can be of interest. For example, you can put preferred engineers in that site, and you can just click on the little plus box and you can say, okay, for this site they like to see Davy Jones working on there. What you can also do is you can also put a service level agreement for that site as well, so any jobs that get created on this site will apply that particular service level agreement. Okay, so going across here, you've got your activity. So very similar to the CRM, it's just got a few things on here, but specific to this site. So you'll see all the job sheets that you have for that site, all the quotes, all the sales orders, projects and contracts that you have. And then from that, you have all the equipment for that site as well. So you could go onto equipment and you can click on new and you could start putting details of a piece of equipment on that site. So as you can see, you can put install date, warranty date, next service date, make, model, anything you want really. Plant location as well, that can be useful so you know where it is. And you can also put a service level agreement for that piece of equipment. Now if you do that, that means that it will pick up the worst case scenario. If you created a job where the site had an SLA and the equipment had an SLA, if the equipment had a lower response time, it will pick that response time. Okay, so once you're happy with that, we'll just click on save and you close that. And then you've got your piece of equipment in here. And what we're going to do is we're actually going to go to another site. We're going to go to the head office one and we're going to select one of these pieces of equipment and we're going to see the view history. So when you click on that, it will view history of any jobs that you've done for that particular site. In this case, it's just the one. So as you can see, there is a job sheet for that particular dishwasher in here. So I'm going to close that. So that's what you can do with equipment. You can see all the history as well. Okay, so if I close that, there is another way of creating equipment. You can see here that you can just go select your site and go equipment and click on new on here as well. And also with your sites, you might have individual contacts for them. And you can put those contacts under the contacts tab on here and just click on new and put a specific contact for that site as well. So if we go to supermarket 5 contacts, click new, we can put in a contact in there. Once you're happy with it, just save and close, and then you've got that contact in there. Now another neat trick from here, it could be a case that you want to go and fix a piece of equipment and you want to create the site, you want to create a job with the site and that piece of equipment. All you need to do is click on the create button and then click create job sheet with selected site, and that will create a job sheet with that piece of equipment, and then you can fill in the description and fill in the details. So it's a real quick way of creating a job sheet with that site and piece of equipment that you've chosen. Another way of using it as well is if you go in to modules, you'll see the sites and equipment tab, and you can do things here by finding the piece of equipment by serial number. So that'll find me anything with the serial number 12345, for example, and again I can just go create job sheet with using selected site and equipment. So if it's a case that they got the serial number of the piece of equipment and you don't want to go finding it for all the massive sites that they have, this is a really good way of creating a job sheet for that piece of equipment. So that's another way of doing it. Okay, so that's it really for the sites and equipment. Thanks very much for listening. Bye.